the 70s of the 20th century, Jos van Bethoff, who was at the time manager of the cleaning department at Schiphol Airport, came up with the idea to put an etched fly in a urinal to reduce splash in the men's restrooms. He got this idea from his time in the army in the 1960s, where he came across small targets placed in the urinals. He noticed that guys are simple-minded and they love to play with the urine stream, so putting something in the toilet bowls made them aim directly at that. While going unnoticed for almost two decades, the Schiphol urinal fly has become famous after having been coined as a prototypical nudge. A nudge is a gentle push to encourage desired behavior in Richard Taylor and Cass Sunstein's book, Nudge: Improving Decisions About Health, Wealth, and Happiness, that was published in 2008. The Schiphol urinal fly even became more famous when Taylor won the Nobel Prize for Economics in 2017. In interviews with the Washington Post, the New York Times, Taylor confirmed that Schiphol urinal fly was his favorite nudge. What is the story behind this intriguing fly? Why might it be Taylor's favorite nudge? Was the fly effective in steering men's behavior in restrooms? And what has become of the fly? As Jos van Bethoff has passed away, as did his supervisor Aart van Kieboom, who was frequently mentioned as one of the co-creators of the fly, we talked with Mariana de Bie, who was at the time Schiphol's spokesperson, and with Abba Slaby, who is now responsible for the airport sanitary services.
We hebben de vlieg genomen en niet gewoon het ronde mikpunt wat Jos van Bethoff tijdens zijn diensttijd had. Omdat we dachten dat het een leuk idee is dat mannen richten op de vlieg om dan de vlieg weg te plassen.
Taylor and Sunstein define a nudge as any aspect of the choice architecture that alters people's behavior in a predictable way without forbidding any options or significantly changing the economic incentives. To count as a mere nudge, the intervention must be easy and cheap to avoid. Nudges are not mandates. The urinal fly meets all the criteria of this definition. It helps men to aim, as to reduce splash, but it also does not forbid them to ignore what the fly wants them to do, which is to aim at the fly as a target. But why has the fly become such an iconic example of a nudge? Some say it is because Dutch design comes with a wink.
Vlieg is jarenlang heel erg beroemd geweest. Toen wij een deelneming kregen in Terminal 4 op John F. Kennedy Airport in Amerika, openden de Amerikaanse kranten ook met The Fly Has Landed in New York. En toen zag men de vlieg dus als een soort van symbool van efficiëntie, maar ook van een knipoog. Dingen doen op een bepaalde Nederlandse manier met een knipoog.
It directly speaks to people and it is funny. Schiphol has recently renovated the sanitary rooms and right now there is only one restroom left with urinal flies. In case if you are wondering, it can be found at Gate D2. Schiphol has not entirely abandoned nudges for helping men aim better, however. They have replaced a fly by a golf hole. Why a golf hole? Because a urinal fly has been patented by the original urinal producer and any new producer should think of an alternative.
Uit de overlevering heb ik begrepen dat de vlieg door Schiphol is bedacht, door Jos. En uiteindelijk is dat ooit een keer bij een fabrikant terechtgekomen, in dit geval was dat Sphinx. En die hebben de vlieg ook gepatenteerd. En wat je ziet bij andere fabrikanten is dat ze een ander embleempje gebruiken.
There seem to be specific requirements for a target that helps men to aim. Particularly, this target should elicit a response to get rid of it without having to feel guilty about it. This means that kind objects such as, for example, a butterfly wouldn't qualify. But the object shouldn't be too scary either. So a big spider or a cockroach wouldn't be good candidates. A fly or a golf hole is a good compromise. Something that makes you want to aim at, but doesn't make you want to run away. They already understood that it works like this in the 19th century because of the first documented urinal target was a bee in a Victorian urinal. Quite a vulgar joke at the time, but it still can be found in Stratford-on-Avon in the UK. Both flies and golf holes seem to work well as gentle suggestions to reduce spillage. Less subtle urinal targets have been documented as well, however, such as images of politicians with their mouths open to steer the urinal stream. While this might be effective, these kinds of objects go far beyond the elegance of the Schiphol fly. Talking about nudges often leads to discussion about the ethics of directing behavior without people being aware of it. How do travelers respond to Schiphol suggesting them to aim better?
Nou, het is mij niet bekend dat daar klachten over binnengekomen zijn. Wel ben ik zelf natuurlijk ook ervaringsdeskundige en intuïtief ga je toch automatisch richting het richtobject.
Then the crucial question. Has the fly been effective in reducing spillage, and has it reduced the cost for cleaning the men's rooms? Whereas in many journal articles it is emphasized that spillage reduction amounted to an astonishing 80%, there has never been any research into this and hard figures are unavailable. Estimates range from 50 to 80% less splashback, which equals with a reduction in cleaning costs of about 8 to 20%.
Ja, op Schiphol is het heel druk en we maken hier intensief schoon. Ik vind het heel lastig om te zeggen dat dat bij ons heel veel oplevert. Wel zien we dat het spetteren in de directe omgeving van zo'n urinoir, dat dat stukken minder is. Dus dat het minder snel vervuilt.
While reducing spillage in the men's room is important for a convenient start of a journey, it may not be the most pressing problem Schiphol is dealing with. Is Schiphol considering using friendly and playful Dutch design for influencing other travelers' behavior? Yes, they are. On June 3, 2019, Cas Sunstein noticed a new yellow navigation sign to the official taxi stand to prevent tired travelers from taking unofficial taxis. He tweeted, "Really good nudge from Schiphol. For tired travelers, this kind of simple navigability aid is a terrific help. And the pleasant yellow signals on the floor take you all the way to a taxi."